Hello everybody, this is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome to a new episode of Let's Play Spyro 2 Ripto's Rage for the PlayStation 1. In our last episode, we started off exploring the Summer Forest homeworld and did all that we could within the limits of our abilities, and we've done pretty much everything we can do to start off with, except learning how to swim, because we don't have enough gems right now to pay money bags over there. So, we're going to start a new level in this episode. We are going to go through Colossus. So, here we go. Alright, here we go. Welcome to Colossus.
A yeti has been rampaging around our home, but we've managed to trap him by shutting all the doors. If you talk to the other brothers, they will open the gates and guide you to him.
Ah, so you have a yeti problem, huh? I think I can fix that. First, let's take out these mountain goats, or rams, whatever they actually are. All we know is they go baa and they have horns. So let's get some treasure. And it actually won't be very long. Maybe about 8 more gems and we'll have enough gems for money bags to teach us how to swim. But we'll worry about that later on.
By concentrating, I should be able to open this door for you.
Surely you don't have some type of mechanism, like a button or something. I'm not sure if chanting is really necessary, and here comes a big yak. They will try to attack you by rolling into you. You can only dispatch them by using the flame attack, which is just fine with me. These gem containers here, and you notice these yellow statues here? These things actually are going to play a part in an orb challenge later in the level, so I'm gonna make mental notes of where all these statues are, because we'll be having to come back to them later.
Who needs a key when you know how to chant like this?
I'm not impressed.
Enemies like those yaks are too big to be charged. Your flame attack should easily take care of large enemies.
Thanks, Zoe. I just said that like 2 minutes ago. Catch up with the times. There will be no dancing in my presence.
When you defeat an enemy, it will release a spirit particle. The spirit particles will activate the power-up in that world. If a power-up is inactive, you need to defeat more enemies.
Did her voice just change? Yeah, it's a thing about the voice acting in this game. It's not entirely consistent. But anyway, as Zoe explained, we have a power-up gate, but we have not defeated enough enemies to activate it. We've got 7 enemies defeated, we need to activate 11, and, yeah, you can hear the Yeti. He's in that building. But we'll deal with him soon enough. First, let me go through and make sure I haven't forgotten any treasure. So yeah, I think this is actually supposed to be, like, the second level in Summer Forest that you do. I think it's like you're probably meant to do Idle Springs first, But since you need to learn how to swim underwater to beat Idle Springs, you know, I'd rather not start Idle Springs and then have to go back out for something else. If I can, I'm going to try to finish every level in one attempt. Although that's not always going to be possible.
Hey, look what I can do!
I've seen better. There's another statue. Extra life! Lives aren't really that important in this game, unless you are playing really, really bad. Although they do come in handy in some of the boss fights. But really, if you're careful and, you know, you play smart, you won't really have to worry about losing lives.
Remember Hunter's advice. You will glide farthest if you press the X button at the very top of your jump.
Although you don't really need that long of a glide to make it over to here. Alright, we got ourselves a bunch of rams over here, so... Yeah, I saw you trying to ambush me. You think I'm stupid? I might not always make the best decisions, but I'm not an idiot. And I missed both those crates. I mean, barrels. Whatever, they had gems, whatever. There's another statue. There's Mr. Yeti. Let's see what's up.
Even though I'm a vegetarian, I think you should kill that Yeti. He's pretty tough, though. In fact, I'm not so sure you're up to it.
We'll see about that. Let's do this! Never mind.
I thought the Yeti was tougher than that. I guess he was all bark. Anyway, I was just guarding our sacred talisman to make sure the Yeti didn't eat it.
Doesn't look like it. That would have been very nutritious. Yeah, Yeti may have been tough, but he wasn't too smart. So yeah, there's the exit portal, but we are far from finished. Not by a long shot. We got a lot of work to do here. And now the power-up is active. This is the, I forget the actual name of it, but it's like something like Super Spring power-up. You walk through this, it's activated automatically, and it will basically launch you to a higher platform. It's basically like a super jump, bounce type of thing. And there's another statue. Like I said, I'm making note of these things for a reason. You're going to see why later on in the level. Let's see. Let's go over here. I think this is the last batch of enemies in the level. So that's all the enemies taken care of. Anything here? Nope, nothing along this wall. That wall is just for display, apparently, so we are going to keep moving on. So, let's see here. Is there anything I can talk about beyond this game? Yes, there is, actually. Earlier in the day, before I recorded this, I was actually playing, Do we have any Pikmin fans out in the audience? Pikmin for the GameCube. I was actually playing that earlier today. And, I forgot how great of a game that game is. That's an excellent game. It requires some strategy and stuff, but it's a pretty good game. But more on that later on. Back to the topic at hand, we have the professor getting harassed by a ghost, by something that looks suspiciously like Ghastly.
Oh, thank goodness you scared that evil spirit away. But now it will hide in the statues. If you were to flame all 10 statues, I'm sure you would chase it away for good.
All right, time for our first orb challenge of this level. We have 10 of those statues that I've been talking about the entire level. Now we have to go find all of them and flame the statues to release the evil spirit, and he will go to another statue. And now you got to repeat this multiple times. But first, we're going to drop down here and get some more treasure. There's a statue right over there. That'll be the next one that we hit. Yeah, I saw those other gems hit the ground. Don't worry, we're gonna grab them and we're gonna grab them on the way back over here. I missed the statue completely. Alright. Are there any towards the beginning area? I actually don't remember where all the statues are. Then again, it has been almost exactly a year since I've played this thing. Because it was literally like almost a year ago. It's going to be a year ago this month that I finished my original Let's Play of this game. Back when I had my old camera and stuff. Go over here, take care of this statue. So anyway, back to what I was talking about earlier when I was talking about a Pikmin. Come on. I was talking about Pikmin, and it was funny because there's a guy on YouTube by the name of Slim Kirby. He's a Let's Player who's a lot more well-known than I could ever be, and he's a lot better at what he does than I could ever be. And he's like one of my inspirations as a Let's Player. A lot of my style and stuff is kind of influenced by him, like commentary and stuff. But anyway, he's currently doing a Let's Play of the original Pikmin, and he kind of inspired me to pick up the game myself, because I had not played it for a number of years until I started watching his Let's Play, and you know, I kind of rediscovered that game. And yeah, it's a pretty good game. So yeah, I thought that'd be a nice little story to tell. Gotta go out through the windows and try not to walk off the edge.
Well done, Spyro! You've scared the evil spirit away! Why don't you take this? I borrowed it from the temple. They don't need it.
And there's our first orb of the level. We now have 5 orbs. But as I said, we're still not done yet. We still have one area that we haven't even explored yet. Whoa. So anyway, I was talking about Slim Kirby and how he's like an inspiration to me and stuff as a Let's Player, so I think that would make a good question of the episode. So I don't do these often. I usually just put them in the description. I don't actually ask them during the video, so here we go. Question of the episode is, if you are a Let's Player like me, who do you cite as an inspiration? Like, who do you adapt your style or choice of games from? Stuff like that. Who is, like, your inspiration? And there it is, all 400 gems. So anyway, question of the episode, what is your inspiration? Who is your inspiration as a Let's Player? Answer in the comment section. So anyway, here's like the last real part of the level we have to do, and this is where we will get our last 2 orbs. So let's talk to this guy here and see what the heck is going on.
Ah, Spyro, welcome! We have found that hockey is a peaceful and calming sport. Would you like to join in a match against our goalkeeper?
I don't know about peaceful and calming. I mean, have you ever watched NHL highlights on ESPN? Anyway, I would love to join in a nice little match. Let's do this.
You have 2 minutes to score 5 goals in the red goal.
Alright, 2-star difficulty. This shouldn't be so bad, although I haven't done this in I literally have not done this in a year. And I haven't played it that much for me to really remember like the back of my hand. So anyway, we gotta pick up the puck. We got 2 minutes to score 5 goals in the goalie goal, so let's see if I can fake him out. And... alright, that's one. Bring it on, buddy. I'm ready. At least he tries to make it challenging by actually knocking the puck away from me. Wow, I didn't think that was going to go in. I had just the best angle for it to go in. That's basically a good tactic, is to try to make him go all the way to one end and then try to shoot at the farther end so that it'll go in before he has a chance to get over and block it. And so we still have over a minute to go, and I just got to score 2 more goals. I think I can do this. Yes, sucker! Faked you out. Oh, he knocks it the other way this time. Nice. Ha ha! Yeah! Quick goal.
Well done! Have this!
Right, here's another orb for us. But we're not done over here yet.
Would you like to try a game of one-on-one?
Sure, why not?
The first to score 5 goals wins. You are shooting at the red goal. Off you go.
Alright, this time we actually have a little bit of competition. We are going against the red skater, and let's go. Now you can fight off the red goal, the red skater, by flaming him. This way you can hold him off. And, aw, crap, he blocked me. Please, goalie, block him. Yes, give the puck right back to him. Yeah, this is a great start. Good job, goalie. You're fired. Hey. No rough tactics out of you, sir. Then again, I can breathe fire, so it's not like I'm any better. Alright, it's tied. Ladies and gentlemen, this is probably going to get pretty intense because I am a very competitive person. And a competitive sport brings out the crazy person in me. So, yeah. I'm probably going to be doing some screaming throughout this. Maybe not screaming, but I'm going to go crazy, probably. This game can actually get pretty intense. Oh, yes! Alright, 3-1. Just keep the puck on their side of the court. Oh my god, I can't believe that went in. I basically got that between the skater and the goalie. And he comes right back and... wow, I went right through him. That was a glitch, man. Glitch! My puck. Hi-ya!
Well done! Have this! If you stare at it long enough, you might not see anything.
Why would I stare at it? Alright, that is the final orb of Colossus. And Colossus is done! Yeah, you can actually jump back in and play some more, but, I think we're done here. Yeah, we don't need to spend any more time. Jeez. For a game where I won 5-2, that was pretty intense at the beginning when I gave up the first goal. But like I said, you want to try to keep the puck on your opponent's side of the rink so that they don't have a chance to score. You know, control the puck, basically. But anyway, Colossus is done. We got the talisman, all the gems, and all 3 orbs. Let us leave. Okay, if you were trying to raise that, why would you stand on it to begin with? Yeah, I like these little, those little cutscenes they show in the level. Some of them are actually pretty funny. Alright, so, as you can see, Colossus is done, we got the talisman, and, we're gonna call it an episode right here, so... That's it for this episode of Let's Play Spyro 2 Ripto's Rage for the PlayStation 1. We have now finished the level Colossus, so we have two levels done, Glimmer and Colossus, for two talismans. And we now have 7 orbs and 855 gems. So this is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. If you liked what you saw in this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see all of you in the next episode.